Smells like a book. Oh, I love that smell. I really do. This arrived, and I'd like to share it with you, if you don't mind. I'll explain what it is, but the first thing I'd like to do is read you just a short paragraph, if you don't mind. It'll kind of bring together the topic I want to speak about today. Are you ready? Okay. Dreams are wondrous things. They really are one of nature's true miracles. We merely close our eyes and be whomever or whatever our imagination can fathom. In our dreams, there are no limits, rules, or permanent repercussions for poor decisions. Flap your arms and you're flying. Imagine the impossible and it becomes possible. Obstacles melt into nothing as the horizons spread out as far as our mind can reach. We wake up in the morning with a fresh reset. Our nocturnal adventure is nothing more than a slowly fading pleasant memory, or at worst, a bitter granule of nastiness that eventually is swept aside as nothing more than an illusion. As children, we live our dreams while asleep, and if we're lucky enough, we bring those dreams with us when we awaken. It's not until later that our elders or life teaches us that dreams are not reality. When our dreams cease to be our reality, well, that's the time we begin to grow up. And that's how the book starts. This is my book. I started this many, many months ago. Actually, I've been writing this for an entire year, I think. And it was at the urging of you. And that's why I wanted to bring this to your attention and to share this with you, because a long time ago, and it was, I think, in 2008, I started my adventure on YouTube. And I do things a certain way, and I act a certain way, I speak a certain way, and my path takes me in a certain direction. And I try to express this in my programs. I don't think I really do much justice, because it's hard to explain everything to everybody all the time. So what I did is people asked me, Ray, why don't you write a book? Put all these things that you're talking about into a book. I thought about it, and at first my initial reaction was, no, I can't write a book. I'm not an author. I'm not. I'm just a guy with a camera and a garden. So this was way beyond anything I can even imagine doing. And one thing I like to tell people, especially here when I'm in the Voodoo Garden, is that all things are possible. And I do believe that, because this was actually possible for me. I sat down one day in front of my computer, and I started typing. I opened up a program and I started typing. I typed a few sentences and it was all wrong. So I deleted it. I started all over again. I deleted that. And I went on this for a while. And then I realized I'm trying. And I really shouldn't try. I should just open up and let myself come out and be put onto paper. And that way, the honest me is going to come out. And that's the best way to do it. And that's what I did. I just didn't think about it. And whatever came to my mind that I wanted you to know, I typed, and it just snowballed. It really went nuts. I started typing, and I couldn't stop. And then I would stop for a while and take a break, and then I would start up again, and it would happen again. So I did this all throughout the year. Whenever the mood would hit me and I knew something needed to come out, it was like a faucet. Once I turned it on, I couldn't stop it. When something needed to come out, I would run to the computer and I would start typing again. Now, my brain is kind of old, so it's kind of like all of this is inside my brain, but it has a real little spigot for it to come out. So it's really going through this real tiny hole, and it kind of wears me out and takes a lot out of me, because I'm not an author. And so I took some time to rest in between writing on these thing on this thing, and but now it's finally done, and it turned out far better than I could possibly even imagine it coming out. And none of this is fake. The one of the things I want to tell you about this, and the name of the book is Today Is a Good Day. And I chose that title not just because it's one of those things I say at the end of the program. It actually has something to do with my life. And it has something very, very important to do with my life. And I would like for you to know this, because everything in this book is a journey from little teeny tiny Ray to right now. It's not all the little boring stuff of growing up and eating soup and going to school and stuff. What I did was I took the life-changing moments and the things in my life that were very instrumental in guiding me to where I am today and making me the person that I am today. And I put them in chronological order in the book. There are There are some sad tales. There are some very happy tales, crazy tales, insane things that I never thought I would mention to anybody and keep a straight face. But it was a labor of love. And it finally came to culmination. And I proofread it. This book was, this is the initial copy. It was printed up a couple weeks ago. I proofed it. I went over it. I read it. I corrected however many typos I possibly can. Now, when you read this, if you do want to read this, and I do hope that you will take a chance on this, when you do open up the book and get into reading it and finding out about me, I hope that you'll excuse some of the typographical things, the misspellings, the syntax errors. Like I said, I'm not an author, and I did this all by myself. I had no other help in doing this other than your help by encouraging me to do it. And I want to thank you, because I do owe you a big debt of gratitude for allowing me to open up and to do this. And I'm really happy to do this, and I hope that you're going to enjoy it as well. This book is a kaleidoscope. I want to tell you just a little bit about it. I'm not going to give away anything in it, because it is an absolutely fantastic read, I think. It's a kaleidoscope of everything in my life that just came together and how it works out. When you read this, you're going to find out certain things like pinto beans, why they mean so much to me. What is it about a pinto bean? What is it about eggs and chickens and this old broken down chicken coop, the lilacs in my backyard? Why apple trees are something special to me, and why I don't practice aquaponics or other kinds of gardening, why I do regular gardening, and also how my life almost ended. So there are some very serious topics in here, but it's put into a format. I made sure it was into a friendly format, just like me talking to you here. This is a book that any adult is going to enjoy on an adult level. Okay, there are no swear words, though. There are no risque terms or anything like that. It's a straightforward me. This is how I am in real life. And I made it in a format that an adult would enjoy, a young person would enjoy also. This is a book that you could easily read to your children, and they would enjoy it as well, because it's a journey. It's kind of like a Huckleberry Finn, Tom Sawyer meets Mother Earth type of thing. I know they're going to enjoy it, because there are many, many stories of me as I grew up as a child, and I think that children would enjoy this as well. Even a child can read this and enjoy it. There are no fancy schmancy terms and words that are going to confuse anybody, but it's not overly simplified. So this is a beautiful culmination of my life, and I would like to offer this to you. Now, I don't want to offer this to you. What I'd like to do is I want to show you something. When I initially wrote this, I didn't know what font to use. So I looked it up online. What font do authors use? I had no idea. I knew nothing about books except that I like to read them. Well, when this came back, I got to show you this. Okay, so I'm going to walk up and show you. It's called Today is a Good Day by Ray Browning. Now, it also has the back and a picture. Now, when you open it up, look, the words are so teeny tiny that I needed a magnifying glass to read this book. It was 200 and something pages long. And that's not a bad size for a book. But the type was way too small. And you know, there's one thing I don't want to do is cause you headaches. That's one thing I won't do for my friends. So what I did is I postponed the offering of the book. I didn't want to sell this the way that it is, because it was not my best. And if I'm going to offer you something for you to purchase, I want to make absolutely certain it is something that is my very best. So second best wasn't good enough. I reworked the book, and I put it into a size of a font that is easier to read. And what it ended up being, I thought, wow, I've been typing for an entire year. Why is it only 200 pages long? I typed a lot of stuff. Well, it's because it was written in microscript. So when I did it into regular format, the way that most books are written, it came out being 334 pages long. Now, let me show you this, okay? All right, here's the original book. See how teeny tiny it is? Now, here is the new one. You can see it's just a little bit bigger, not too awful much bigger. I wasn't trying to make more pages by making the font bigger. I was just trying to make it readable. But it's small enough to where it's regular book type, but it's just a little bit more readable than this. It's the exact same book, front and back, but look at the difference in sizes. See? This has some weight to it. It's a regular book, folks. Okay, now that that's all said, I'm going to post a link in the video description underneath this program. If you scroll down after you're done with this program and click on the link, it will take you to the website. It's an actual publisher, a publishing website called Lulu. It's definitely a regular publishing website. It's reputable, it's safe, and it's secure. Okay, and that is the publisher is selling my book. And you can purchase this online. They do take credit cards and debit cards. Now, what it's going to do is come to you in a regular box in the mail, and it's got bubble wrap to help protect the book, and it's got cardboard around it, so it's going to be very well protected. This is how you're going to receive my book in the mail. I wanted to show you that so you don't think it's coming in an envelope. It's not coming from me. It's coming from the actual publisher. And I do make a few dollars off of this book, and the publisher makes a few dollars because they're running it through their presses, and they're also selling it on their website, so they get a cut out of it too. So there's really nothing I could do. And but I wanted to make sure that I could get this out, and I could get it out in a format that I'm very proud of. And I gotta say, patting myself on the back, I am very proud of this book. I think it is one of the great things that I've done in my life, and I'm very glad that I did it. And one last time, I want to thank you. I want to thank you for having confidence in me and being patient with me, and also for prodding me along, because I know I wouldn't have done this without you. And it's something that I'm really happy to share. And what I would like to do is once you get the book and once you read it, if you ever have any questions about this, if you want to talk about what's in this, I would be more than happy to do that. What I'd like to do is later on this winter, and even farther down the road, I'm going to be live streaming. And I do have my computer, I have my monitor, I have everything down here in the Voodoo Garden, and I can live stream. And we can talk. We can talk books. And I think that would be fine. Now that that's all said, I'm going to be doing the paperback copy of the book initially. Then once the run is through, I don't know how long this is going to take. It may take weeks, months, I don't know. But once the final run is done and the book is slowing down on sales, I'm going to focus on an e-book. And that is just an electronic book that you can read on a Kindle or online. That I'm also going to focus on, but I don't have any idea how to do that now. I have other things I need to start doing. Once I get this book out, I have to start packaging seeds for the seed giveaway. So I have a lot of things on my plate. And so I'm going to be working on that. But I promise you, I will eventually get an ebook, and I'm also considering doing an audiobook. I'm not sure about that, if I can do that, because I don't know if I can read a whole book out loud. I don't know. Maybe I'll try. I'm not going to promise anything, but I'm not going to say I won't do it. Okay? And what I'm doing with this is the same as what I did with the compost is I'm selling this as a fundraiser for myself to earn a few dollars to put towards the continuation of the farm and projects that I want to do on the farm. And it makes me feel a lot better knowing that I'm able to offer you something in return for your financial assistance here on what I do on the farm. And I think that this is going to be well worth the money, and I know that you're going to enjoy it. Okay, that all being said, I want to thank you very much for taking the time to join me here and to listen to me talk about this. And if you have any questions, post it in the comment section below. Otherwise, click on the link below the video, and the book is available and it's ready to go. Thank you everybody for joining me. I really do appreciate it. And like I always say, have a great day.